Welcome to White Wall Wednesday. My name is Brooke, and we are going to do a sort of dark, surreal photo shoot, which is not surprising if you know my photography, but this is going to be an extra fun one. I'm going to put myself in the image twice, so we're going to learn how to put two people into a single photo, and we're going to play heavily with perspective. So in the final image, I'm going to be on the wall and on the floor at the same time, and there are going to be a couple of elements interacting between both figures that require a lot of thought ahead of time to make it look realistic. So join me for this video. We're going to talk about how to composite multiple people into an image, how to work with different perspectives, and how to create a dark, surreal photo. If this video is valuable to you, then I would love for you to subscribe to my channel, give this video a like, and leave a comment. That helps me make more videos like this, and I want very much to be able to serve you. So if you have any ideas of things that I haven't covered that you would like to see more in depth, please let me know. I also have lots of classes online, hundreds of hours of classes. So if you want to support me outside of YouTube, you can go take a look at my classes. It's linked below. And I have, like I said, hundreds of hours of tutorials between conceptualizing, shooting, editing, and the business of fine art photography. I want to give you a quick overview of where I shoot these images. So right now I'm in my office, and inside my office, I have some constraints. It's pretty tiny. And I'll give you a quick tour of what that looks like. This is the wall that I normally shoot on, but I wanted to show you the rest of my shooting space. I usually take this picture down. And my room is pretty small, so it's about 10 feet by 10 feet. This is a failed attempt at a wall bed that's just still there taking up space. It's not super clean, I apologize, but this is kind of it. So when I shoot my images, it's right here, typically with this natural light coming in this direction. So it's a little bit in front, a little bit to the side, and that allows for some really dynamic shooting. If I need something more from the side, then I'll just flip it around and shoot there by hanging a sheet on this bed, this mattress. And that's how I handle that. And then I do the same thing for this wall. I just hang something on my door, my closet door's there, if I need to edit or shoot something with the light coming straight in. And this light I really just use for video, but sometimes it can help with shooting too. As you can see, I intentionally create a blank space in here. I normally have a picture hanging on this wall. I take that down every week when I film a new video, and that way I have a nice blank space. If you don't have a space that you can make blank by moving furniture or pictures or whatever might be there, then go ahead and hang a bed sheet behind you wherever you're going to shoot, and that works just fine. So you don't have to have a totally blank space to make it look really neutral and ready to go for a photo shoot. I'm also shooting in a pretty modern space. So you'll notice that floorboards, the baseboard, my wall, they're pretty indicative of a new house. My house was built about 4 years ago. And because of that, it doesn't quite have the right dark, grimy feel that I want it to have. So I utilize Photoshop to make it look a little bit more disgusting so that I don't have to live in a place that looks like that to be able to create in a space that looks like that. I add texture, I add drips of gross stuff in the walls, and I try to do the same thing for the floors, make them a little bit darker, a little bit more mysterious, and that way it looks like I'm shooting in a dark space when in fact it's actually pretty nice and bright in here. The gist of this image, which might not be totally easy to see by just looking at it, is that I'm going to be laying on the wall on my stomach, sort of like if you imagine like a slumber party and like a bunch of people just like hanging out on the bed with their legs up in the air, that kind of thing. I don't know, is that a normal vision, or is this like some weird 90s movie that I saw? I don't know. But that's how I'm going to be posed for one of the shots, and for the other one I'm going to be on the floor. So it's going to be like a weird perspective thing where one person is stuck to the wall, one person is on the floor, and the person that is up on the wall is going to be controlling the person on the floor with strings like a marionette doll. I just changed out of this dress because it's a little bit vintage, but not quite the right feeling that I'm going for. I always try to choose dresses that are very neutral, that have a nice texture to them, and that can't be easily placed within a time period. So this is my favorite dress that I own, and this is what I'm going to use for the shoot. So goodbye, rainbow dress. We're done with you. And a couple of more things that I have to think about other than wardrobe are hair. So if I am shooting myself on the wall, I need to think about if my hair should be falling down or if it should be stuck to the wall. And for this particular image, I want it to be stuck to the wall. So instead of shooting my hair falling or flying, I'm just gonna shoot it on the floor. So let's shoot that image first. This should be a fine place to create from, because what I'm going to do here is sort of get in position that I want to be for the final shot. And if I'm laying here, then the light coming in from the window should be the same essentially as what it is on the wall. That's not to say that there won't be things that have to be changed or that something, you know, won't be quite exactly right, but that's okay because we can work on that later. So I'm taking my hair down, because I know that I want my hair to be down instead of up so that it looks more timeless. And I just have to flip over and get the actual shot in this position. So I'll be like this in the final shot, sort of like that. To shoot the main pose, I've got my arm wrapped up and I'm going to do a pose sort of like this to look like the ropes are coming down and holding on to my wrist, which it is. For the main pose here, I'm trying to make my dress look nice and big, like it's really sitting on the floor, cover up my legs. I've got the rope tied around, so that looks realistic, and I'm gonna do that on both hands. So I already shot this hand, so now I'm unraveling, and I'm just gonna switch it over to this one and do some of the similar poses that I just tried to make it look like both hands are really wrapped up in rope. That means that I will have to add one different hand on to the main pose, but that's not a huge deal as long as I can match the pose pretty well. The one that I like the most is when I have this arm up and this one down, so I'm going to mimic that right now and see if I can get some good shots of this hand all tied up. The key in Photoshop is to start with your main image, and your main image is sort of the easiest place to ground yourself within a composited shot. So for me, the main image will be me sitting on the floor, the marionette doll part. And from there, I'll start to build out the wall and the floor and the baseboard so that it looks like a much bigger room than I'm actually in. That way I'll have enough space to add in all of the extra elements, like the me sitting on the wall and the strings that I have to add in between the two figures. Those things will be vital to truly seeing the space for what it can be, for what it will be, which is a really big, dark, scary room where there's this girl sitting on the wall controlling the girl on the floor. It's a very weird composite, but I think it's gonna be really fun. The next thing that I want to think about is how to best tell this story. I ended up wearing this really neutral gray dress because I wanted to create an interesting dichotomy between these two characters. By choosing a neutral gray dress, I could either keep it neutral and then the dress would be really second fiddle to everything else going on, or because it's gray, it gives me the opportunity to change the color slightly to be darker and lighter, or one color versus another, and that way I can create some subtle separation between the two figures. One might be wearing a dark dress, one might be wearing a light dress. One might be wearing red and one blue, who knows? So the opportunities there are numerous and give me greater ability to tell the story of who these characters are and how this is taking place. Thank you for watching this White Wall Wednesday video. I hope that it helps you in seeing your own space, no matter what it looks like, in a more creative way. I can't wait to see what you make. Please do share this video if it was helpful for you, or if you think that it might be helpful to somebody else that you know. And if you do create a White Wall Wednesday image, make sure that you hashtag it with White Wall Wednesday portraits and share it in the comments below so that I and other people can see it. Thank you so much. Bye.